Hi students, so we are going to start a new chapter, that is Jainism and Buddhism. So what is the main syllabus of this chapter? What we need to give more concentration in this chapter, that is about the syllabus is given here. It is Jainism and Buddhism, sources, angas, tripitikas and jatakas. A brief mention is needed. Then causes for their rise in the 6th century BC and their main doctrines. That is what we need to discuss mainly in this chapter. Okay, so let us move. I will give a short introduction. So in the 6th century, Aryans, they came to India. Okay, and they began to start new kingdoms. They set up kingdoms. And the same way Indians also, by the end of the later Vedic period, the people began to lead a settled life. You know what is settled life? They invented implements. Okay, they started to live near the river banks. So they started to live together. Okay, when they started to live together, they started to expand their areas. They set up a city or a village. Then they tried to set up a new village, or they tried to capture the new village on the nearby areas. So this led to wars between the villages or between the areas. Okay, like this it formed a kingdom. Okay, so this kingdom at the time it is called Janapadas. What is it called? It is called Janapadas. When these kingdoms joined together, it came to be known as Mahajanapadas. Also, the 6th century is very important with the emergence of some new thinkers or social reformers and ideologies. That is about Swarashtra, Mahavira. In India especially it is about Mahavira and Gautama Buddha. And why they are important? They gave way for a new religion and new ideologies. Okay, so now we are going into detail. How could we know about the details about Buddhism and Jainism? What are the sources? From where do we get knowledge about these religions? That is the sources. What they are saying is the three important sources which provide information about Jainism and Buddhism are the following. First one is Anga. These are mainly Angas, Tripitikas are there. Okay, and Jataka. These are the literary works. From these three literary works, we get knowledge about these both religion, Buddhism and Jainism. And what is about Angas? What it is? Angas, it is mainly accepted that whatever Lord Mahavira taught after gaining omniscience. What is omniscience? Omniscience means the enlightenment, getting knowledge from God. Complete knowledge. And he knows everything related to the world, related to God, every knowledge. Knowledge related to any matters. That is called omniscience. Okay. And after getting enlightenment, what he taught, his teachings, it included in a book, 12 volumes of book, that is known as Angas. These are collectively known as Dvadashangi. These 12 Angas, 12 books are there. These 12 books together, it is known as Dvadashangi. So I can mention the names here, Angas, okay, and Dvadashangi. The foremost of these Anga is Acharang Sutra. What is Acharang? The first one, the foremost or the most important, we can say it is Acharang Sutra. Another well known Anga is the Vyakhya Prajnapati. What is Vyakhya Prajnapati? Or in simple words we can say Bhagavadi Sutra. Okay, Acharang Sutra or Bhagavadi Sutra. The former, the first one, Acharanga Sutra deals with code of conduct with a Jain monk is required to follow. The first one, Acharanga Sutra, what it is? How a Jain sannyasi lead a life. The rules and regulations related to that, it is explained in Acharanga Sutra. And in the second one, the Jain doctrines in a comprehensive manner. The teachings and the ideologies of Jainism is explained in the Bhagavad Sutra. Based on these angas, the seers or sannyasis compiled 12 auxiliary works that came to be known as Upangas. Based on these three works or these two works, the sannyasis wrote some another books. That means we have supplementary books that can be known as Upangas. It is said that these Angas and Upangas were not written for a long time. They were orally passed on by the religious leaders to their peoples. So from the beginning, it was not in the written form. From the beginning onwards, it was not in the written form. How did they pass? They taught, the sannyasis taught their disciples, these disciples taught their disciples for a number of years. It was not written, so later it was written. According to the famous historian R.C. Majumdar, towards the close of the 4th century BC, a famine in South Bihar led to the exodus of important section of Jainas headed by Bhadrabahu to South India. Those that remained behind Pataliputra called for a council in order to revive the knowledge of the Angas. The result was the compilation of the 12 Angas at another council held at Vallabhi in Gujarat in the 5th and 6th century AD. A final collection of the scriptures was made for the first time in Ardhamagadhi Prakrit language. The Angas were regarded as the most important part of Jain doctrines. They discussed religious rites, stages of household life, the vows of chastity, rules of conduct, and other features of Jain philosophy. The rest of things, because of the famine that happened in Bihar, the Jain people went to the South India. Okay, some other parts of, we can say, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, like those areas. Okay. And the other things, what is the main content of these Angas? What is the main content of these Angas? These Angas mainly deal with, what is the main content? Religious rites, how to perform pujas of Jainism, and stages of how to live a household life, a marital life, a family life. Then vows of chastity, how to live a unmarried life. Rules of conduct, how to behave. And other features of Jain or other Jain philosophy is explained here in the Anga. So hope that what is Anga is clear for you. Okay. Now we are moving to the second book, that is Tripitikas. Anga is the book of Jainism. Tripitika is the book of Buddhism. What is Tripitika? The meaning of Tripitika is, the meaning of Tripitika is three baskets. Important literary books related to Buddhism is called Tripitika. Tripitika means it is three basket. Okay. What is in three basket? What is explained in these three baskets? Okay. It is written in Pali language. Another important thing is it is written in Pali language. Okay. What is explained? First book is the Vinaya Pitaka. Deals with the rules and regulations which Buddha promulgated for the monks and the nuns. Okay, what is Vinaya Pitaka? It is a directions given to the Buddhist monks and nuns, to sannyasis, the common, to the male and female, how to live their life. Okay, how to live the life. That is what it is given in the Vinaya Pitaka. Also, it gives light or it gives knowledge about the Indian history at the time and the customs arts of that period. Now, the second book, The second book is Sudapidika. It comprises discourses on various occasions. Also, it has discourses by some disciples of Buddha, such as discourses means the teachings, the preachings. Okay, that means you can say the conversations or the teachings Buddha taught, how the Buddha, the main content of his teachings. In Sudapidika, it explains about the main teachings of or the preachings, where the preachings to his disciples or to the people. It not only deals with the preachings of Buddha, but it also deals with the preachings of his disciples also. Whose disciples? Buddha's disciples. Okay. And the third one, it is about Abhidhamma Pidaka. What it is? Abhidhamma Pidaka. It deals with the Buddhist philosophy. It describes things life like the working of human mind and state of matter. The mainly Abhidhamma Pidaka deals with the philosophy, Buddhist philosophy. Mainly about what? About the human mind, and we call it psychology. How Buddha defines the human mind, or the states of human mind, or states of life, the physique. Okay, all these explained in the three book or the three basket, three pitikas, three basket. Besides being the most reliable source of information about Buddhist religion, philosophy, the PDFs provide a glimpse of the social, economic and political life of the age of Buddha. It is not only about the Buddhism. Rebidika gives knowledge not only about Buddhism, it also gives knowledge about that particular times, social, economic and political life. Okay, about the history. Okay, then next one is the third sources of knowledge is Jatakas. What is Jataka? In short, we can say this is stories about Buddha. This is the stories about Buddha. Okay, that means the Hindus believe that there are different lives. A human being or for a particular soul, okay, the life, it takes place differently. For a time he can be animal, and another time he can be an insect, or for another period of time he can be a tree or a plant, for another time he can be some other creatures. So like this, human or the human soul takes different forms of life. So this Jataka speaks about the Buddha's such different forms of life and the incidents happened in this. And in these incidents, it happens or end the story with a moral. So you might have heard about Jataka tales. Okay, this is the moral stories. The main character is Buddha. Okay, Buddha takes different forms of life. It can be animal or a plant or a human being itself or some insects. Different animal forms. And with the end of the story, it gives a moral to the humans. How you have to live. Or what type sorts of life you have to lead. To the moral values. It is giving instructions. That it is called the Jataka tales. Or what it is? It is equal to the Mahabharata. Or some, as we know, the Aesop's fables. Aesop's of fables. Like that, these are fables, stories. Okay, what is Jataka is clear for you. Now we are moving to the reason for the origin of Buddhism and Jainism. Okay, reason for the origin of Buddhism and Jainism. What are the reasons for the origin of Buddhism and Jainism? First one, you need to mainly concentrate on some 3-4 points only. Okay, instead of concentrating on all the points, what is easy for you, concentrate on this. Reaction against ritualism. What is reaction against ritualism? Okay, at the time when the Hindu religion, there were a number of rituals and pujas, sacrifices were there, which were not able to affordable to the normal people, the poor people. Okay, you have to do some sacrifices, pujas, yajnas. which were not at all affordable for, which were not at all affordable for the poor people. Okay, so that is one reason why the people changed into Jainism and Buddhism, because it did not give any importance to the yajnas or yagas or any pujas or sacrifices. The people automatically changed into what? Buddhism and Jainism, because these rituals and pujas and yajnas were very costly, which were not affordable to the poor people. It spent a lot of money, so there was no money in the poor people. So what did they moved to a way where they can satisfy, or they can please God, where they can please God with whatever they are having. Okay, they did not go to the gods who demanded them high rituals or high sacrifices or high yajnas or yagas. That was the reason. Second one, corruption in the religion. Second point is, already we said the yajnas and yagas and sacrifices, the Brahmins, they collected a huge amount of money from the people. Okay, because to perform such a things, they collected a huge amount of money from the people. And this, the people, so it is as a corrupted thing. It's a corruption, because they were using the people. Yajnas, whenever there is an opportunity for a Brahmana, they said, to solve this problem in your house or in your kundali. What do you say? In your kundali, what do you have to do? You have to perform this. So they were misusing this. Who? The Brahmanas. They were misusing these yajnas and yagas to collect money, to attain wealth. So the people detained from the Hindu religion and they moved to Jainism and Buddhism. Next one is a rigid caste system. You know what is caste system. The Indian society was divided into four castes. That is Brahmanas, Kshatriyas, Vaisyas and Shudras. And the Hinduism promoted which religion, which caste? Mainly the, it gave priority to the Brahmanas and Kshatriyas mainly. So the other two sects of people, Vaisyas and Shudras, they moved to the Jainism and Buddhism. And then difficulty language. Okay, the Hinduism followed the Sanskrit language. Mostly the books are in Sanskrit language, which was not at all understood for the local people. But the important thing is, the books that is written, or the teachings of Jainism and Buddhism, it was in the local language of the people. So it was easy for them to understand. So they moved. So they moved to the alternate religion, that is Jainism and Buddhism. Now then, political situation. What was the political situation? The rulers, some of the rulers, famous rulers, you can say Bimbisara, Ajatashatru, all those famous rulers of Pataliputra. And what did they do? Magadha, okay? What did they do? Okay, when they understood these are better religions than Hinduism, even they started to accept the Jainism and Buddhism. So by seeing that, the people followed them. That is a political situations. Okay, even the kings, the famous kings, they followed the religions of Jainism and Buddhism. By seeing that, when the king does, the people also follows. Okay, so the people followed. Then the agriculture economy, that is killing of animals. So the Hinduism, as I said, the Hinduism promoted sacrifices, mainly the killing of animals. The killing of animals, a farmer may be having two ox or two cows, maybe to do work in his area of land, do farming. But when the Brahmana asked to do sacrifice, so he has no other option, because he has only one cow or one goat or whatever he is having with him, very less amount of animals he is having. So when he asked him to perform yajnas or yagas by killing these animals, he doesn't have any other option. He has to perform. At the same time, to do farming, he doesn't have any more options. He doesn't have one more animal with him. He need to buy. So they rejected such customs. They were against such customs. They were not ready to give away or to sacrifice their animals. their livelihood. So they moved to Jainism and Buddhism. Already we discussed what are the six reasons for the causes of rise of Buddhism and Jainism. First one is reaction against the ritualism. Second one is corruption in the religion, rigid caste system, difficult language. Third one, political situation. Then last one is agriculture economy. This is about the first part. Main thing is this. Now we will next in the next class we will see mainly about the doctrines of Jainism and Buddhism. Okay, then with that I will give the notes also. So hope that you understood. If you have not understood anything, already this we have completed in the online classes. So if you have if you can go for further details, you can refer this. Okay, if you have any doubt, you can comment or you can ask in the live class. Thank you.